Hey guys, Chef Anita here. Okay, what am I looking at right now? Well. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. We are making some cornflake encrusted baked chicken tenders. And we'll be serving that tonight with a side of mashed potatoes and maybe a little sliced watermelon. Who knows? We'll see. I am making these for a very special reason, and that special reason, I would love nothing more than to talk about it, but it has to do with Dwayne's business, and I really don't have the vocabulary other than the man is brilliant. So I am making these tenders, these tendies for him in honor of him. And so now, I have never made this before. When my daughter and I went to Austin, Texas, she had her first bite of a cornflake encrusted chicken tender. I've heard of it, I've never done it. So I decided to come home and again make this for Dwayne, but also for her because the girl is in love with this texture and the flavor. So I went ahead and pulsed some cornflakes in my Robocoup with one secret ingredient. And if you could tell me what that secret ingredient is in this crust, well, then you're a winner. And we'll have to figure out a prize, aren't we? I wonder what that could be. Anyway, so this has basil, garlic powder, onion powder, a little cayenne. I also have salt and pepper, coriander. And a little bit of that Mexican oregano in here. Toss with the secret ingredient. And I, like I said, put some of these, I put most of them, like 3/4 of the 5 cups of cornflakes that I'm using, into the Robocoup, pulse to the right consistency. And then I hand crushed the other cup so that you could have, again, textural difference. See that? You got big, small. There you go. So this is going to get encrusted, this chicken, with a little bit of dusting of flour, and then we're going to, well, we dredge it here, and then we go into the wet ingredient, which will be a little bit of non-fat milk and a couple of eggs, nice and whipped, and then into the actual cornflake. And then I'm going to place it onto a wire rack and oven bake it at 375 for about 15 minutes. Then I'm going to flip them over and then I'm going to cook the other side for another 10-15 minutes. Again, depending on the size and the quantity that you have in the oven, don't overcrowd your rack. If you need to have a second one, please do it. It makes all the difference. You want a crispy tender here. So that's what we're serving tonight. And again, I'm just making a simple mashed potato on the side, and then I'll have some greens, and again, maybe a little sliced watermelon. And that's going to be dinner tonight. Just very simple. I have some of that barbecue sauce in there, some of the hot salsa that I made with the chimayo chilies. So we are set and good for tonight. Sorry about my dishes. I haven't been home all day. Anyway, so see you guys soon, okay?